Hello student of class 12, once again we are here with a new video, and in this video we are going to cover the chapter semiconductors. And in this chapter, before starting, there are few terms which I want to tell you. That is, first is energy band. So what is energy band? In an isolated atom, the valence electrons can exist only in one of the allowed orbitals and each of sharply defined energy called energy levels. Means एक isolated atom में valence electron कुछ अपनी sharp defined energy shell में घूम सकते हैं, and that is called energy level, means that has certain amount of energy. But when two atoms are brought nearer to each other, there are alteration in the energy level and they spread in the form of bands. These are called energy bands. So in any material there are two type of energy bands. One is valence band and the second one is conduction band. So what is valence band? The outermost shell that determines the conductivity is called valence band, and the conduction band, the band outside of the valence shell. So in valence band, the energy band formed by series of energy levels containing valence electron is known as valence band. And at 0 Kelvin, the electrons fill the energy level in valence band starting from lowest one. So what are the properties of this band? This band is always fulfilled by electron, means electron is always in this band. This is the band of maximum energy. Electrons are not capable of gaining energy from external electric field, and no flow of current due to such electrons, means valence electrons are not responsible for the flow of current. And the highest energy level which can be occupied by an electron in valence band at 0 Kelvin is called Fermi level. These are the important points related to valence band. Now what is conduction band? The conduction band, the higher energy level band is called conduction band. It is also called empty band of minimum energy. This band is partly filled by electrons. In this band, the electrons can gain energy from external electric field, and the electrons in the conduction band are always called free electron, or maybe they are called free electron, and they are able to move anywhere within the volume of the solid. And the responsibility of the current means the current flows due to such electron. So this is very important that the current flows due to the electrons which are found in the conduction band, and there is no flow of current due to the electron which are in the valence band. These two lines are very important. So whatever the point I discuss you about the valence band and conduction band, we have to listen it very carefully, and you have to make notes, note it down on your copy, because these are the very important points related to valence band and conduction band. So the two bands are separated by one energy gap, which is called forbidden gap, or we can also call it forbidden energy gap. It is denoted by delta EG. If you see in your book, the symbol for energy gap is EG. G for gap and E for energy. So the energy gap between the conduction band and valence band is known as forbidden energy gap. And no free electrons present in the forbidden energy gap. And width of the energy gap depend upon the nature of the substance. As you increase the temperature, the forbidden energy gap decreases very slightly. So the electrons can move to the conduction band if it have enough energy. And what we had learned in the previous chapter, the photoelectrons, they are emit with the help of that light, and the thermions with the help of heat. So if the electron are gaining some energy due to light and heat, they can move to the conduction band. When the electrons absorb enough energy to jump from valence band to the conduction band, the electron is said to be in an excited state. So these are the few terms which we had discussed in this: valence band, conduction band, forbidden energy gap, and you have to make it in your point form and see from the book also. So the next, if you see in this figure, the energy and the energy gap is shown in the three diagram. The first for insulator, if you see the valence band and the conduction band, there is a wide gap between the two bands, and if you see in the semiconductors, the band gap is very small, and if you see in the case of conductor, the conduction band and valence band, they are overlap each other. So the concept of energy band is particularly important in classifying the materials as conductors, semiconductors and insulator. So semiconductors have a smaller forbidden band and require less energy to move an electron from the valence band to the conduction band. Therefore, for the certain amount of applied voltage, more current will flow in the semiconductor than in the insulator. Means insulator, if you provide amount of energy or amount of voltage increase, but there will be no flow of current. But in the case of semiconductor, after a certain applied voltage, it is possible that the current will flow. So this is the semiconductor, which is in between the conductor and insulators. If you see from your NCRT, there is a difference given between the resistivity and conductivity of the semiconductors, insulators and conductors. So that is very important part, and you have to go on that page, and also you have to make notes for that what is the resistivity and conductivity for the metals, semiconductors and insulators. Now semiconducting element, they have the low electrical conductivity at room temperature, and electrical conductivity increases with temperature. Gap between valence and conduction band is intermediate in size in a semiconductor. If you had seen the figure also. Semiconducting element from the basis of the solid state electronic devices, metalloids such as silicon or germanium are semiconducting elements whose electrical conductivity increases as the temperature increases. Means if you increase the temperature, the electrical conductivity may be increase of the semiconductor, but it is not advised that you can increase the temperature to make it conductor, because after a certain allowed temperature, they melt also. A striking property of these elements is that their conductivity increases markedly when they are doped with the smaller quantities of the other element. Means to make it a conductor, to make it to flow current, the one arrangement is there that we can add some impurity from outside, which is called doping. And due to doping, we can make the semiconductors to use as a conductors. We will discuss this thing in this coming chapter about doping and dopant. And it was also in the part of chemistry in the class 11th also. So semiconducting material made from the materials that have four valence electrons in their outer orbit. And germanium and silicon are the most common semiconducting element. They have four electrons in their outermost shell, and silicon is preferred due to ability to withstand heat. A pure semiconductors material such as silicon or germanium has no special properties and will make a poor conductive material. So if you compare the property of conductors, insulators and semiconductor, the conductivity, resistivity and band structure or energy gap, if you see for all the semiconductors, conductor, insulator, you have to make a table and make it compare on the basis of electrical conductivity, resistivity, band structure, energy gap and current carriers. Now, when the silicon is doped with phosphorus, it becomes n-type semiconductor in which electrical current is carried by negative charge electron. Means when that silicon is doped with impurity of phosphorus, phosphorus have 5 electron in their outermost shell, and when it is doped with the silicon, extra electron is capable to make it conductor. So this is called, since electron is negative, it is released by the phosphorus. So we can say that due to negative, it is called n-type semiconductor. Earlier it was the pure semiconductor, but when it is doped with the phosphorus, silicon is now become n-type of semiconductor. N means negative, and negative means electron. Electron is donated by the phosphorus. So now the type of semiconductor is n-type semiconductor. And when the silicon is doped with boron, The boron has the three electron in the outermost shell, and when it doped with the silicon, one hole is there where no electron is there. The hole is considered as positive because the electron is leave from there. So when the electron moves from there, it means that is positive. So hole is there. There is a space which is termed as hole, and hole is considered as positive. Means the p-type semiconductor formed when the silicon or pure silicon is doped with the boron, or we can say trivalent. When the silicon or germanium is doped with the trivalent, it is of made p-type semiconductor, and the when the silicon or germanium is doped with the pentavalent, it is formed n-type semiconductor. And when you join the p-type semiconductor to n-type semiconductor, we are getting a junction which is called p-n junction, and it is of so many uses. We will also discuss this in this chapter. An important term is the rectifier. Rectifier is a device that allows the current to flow in one direction only. So we have two type of rectifier. One is half wave rectifier and the full wave rectifier. This also we are going to discuss in this chapter. So these are the few terms I am discussing here. This is an introduction video for this semiconductor. So I am giving you the few terms. You have to go through this term from your NCERT also. You have to read the pages from first and second page of your NCERT book to know that what are these terms and how can you understand about these. So the type of semiconductors are two types. Semiconductors are mainly of two types, intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic semiconductor means chemically very pure and possess poor conductivity. It has equal number of negative carrier, that is electron, and positive carrier, that is hole, and impurity do not affect its electrical behavior. Means intrinsic means is a pure semiconductor which is without conductivity, but when it is doped from the any other element, then it will become extrinsic. Intrinsic semiconductor, if you see that silicon has four outer shell electron, that is called valence electron. And if they are forming a lattice, if they are forming a crystal of silicon, so they are sharing the electron to each other. So this is the one pictorial, or we can say one picture for this extrinsic semiconductor, in which the silicon had make one crystal and they are sharing electron with each other. Now extrinsic semiconductor, improved intrinsic semiconductor with a small amount of impurities added by a process known as doping process, which alters the electrical property of the semiconductor and improves its conductivity. Means whenever the pure semiconductor is make impure by adding some impurities from outside, it is called doping process, and this doping process changes the behavior of semiconductor. Now it behave like a conductor, or we can say we can improve the electrical conductivity of this semiconductor. So introducing the impurities to the semiconductor material can control their conductivity, and the introducing of the impurity to the semiconductor is called doping process, and what we are adding is called dopant. So doping and dopant are the two new terms for you all, and I think that it is also discussed in the class 11th, some part of the chemistry. Doping and dopant. Doping is the process of adding impurity, and dopant is a substance which is added to the pure semiconductor. Now adding impurity atom into the intrinsic semiconductor is make that extrinsic semiconductor. Means if you are adding something from outside to the intrinsic semiconductor, now it is termed as extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic means impure semiconductor, and intrinsic means pure semiconductor. The process of adding a specific type of atom to a semiconductor to favorable alter the electrical characteristic is called doping, and there are two type of extrinsic semiconductor, n-type and p-type. We will discuss in the next video what is n-type and what is p-type, and we will also discuss about the energy band, energy gap also. This is the intro video for you all. You have to go through your NCERT for these terms what we had used in this video to understand properly, and then we are going to start again that what we had learned in this and continue the chapter with these terms. So my advice is that you go through your NCERT, compare the conductivity, resistivity and of this semiconductor, insulator and metals, and what are the examples of semiconductors? Semiconductors are of different type. How can we dope? What is doping? What is dopant? And what is intrinsic and what is extrinsic? These are the terms. This is which is used in this video. It will help you to understand, and also you have to make notes of these terms because these are the very important and new terms for you all. So once again, if you have any problem, if you're not getting anything, you message me, you call me, or you can make a note and drop in the message, and I will free it and I will call to you. Till then, thank you, have a nice day.